Before we starting this summary of the book, let's talk about the author of this book. Gary Bruce Wilson is the author of the best-selling book Your Brain on Porn, Internet Pornography and the Emerging Science of Addiction, presenter of the immensely popular TED Talk, The Great Porn Experiment, and creator of the website yourbrainonporn.com, a clearinghouse for the latest research, media, and self-reports on pornography's effects and potential harms. Gary Wilson taught human pathology, anatomy, and physiology for years and has long been interested in the neurochemistry of addiction, mating, and bonding. Wilson possessed a gift for teaching, a passion for compiling information, and an unwavering desire to help others. After he noticed many young people online experiencing adverse effects associated with excessive porn use, he created yourbrainonporn.com in late 2010. Since the corresponding book was first published in 2014, Your Brain on Porn has been translated into Arabic, Dutch, German, Hungarian, Japanese, and Russian. In 2016, Wilson co-authored an academic paper with 7 U.S. Navy doctors entitled, Is Internet Pornography Causing Sexual Dysfunctions? A review with clinical reports, and another journal article entitled, Eliminate Chronic Internet Pornography Use to Reveal Its Effects. Gary Wilson's tireless work in cataloging the research surrounding the effects of porn use touched countless lives worldwide. Now let's start the summary of the book, Your Brain on Porn. For better understand, we are divided this book into various parts or topics. Researcher Gary Wilson in the book, Your Brain on Porn, has enlightened the readers with the idea of how internet porn is a curse for the today's growing generation. Part 1. How porn is affecting today's generation. Even one is a student, professional or a sports person, this one habit distracts the person towards his, her goals, dreams, better life and good mental health. Many people do not feel right watching porn and masturbate, but they are habituated towards it and can't help it. They do not know the way of avoiding it and not repeating the process. Gary Wilson has cited in the book, Your Brain on Porn, how porn affects the brain in a worse way and what all is concluded by the experts researching over the topic since years. Pornography has been present in form of arts and communication since centuries, but internet has made it accessible so vastly that one is only a few clicks away from watching porn. Porn is a phenomenon that affects one's life, thoughts and desires, and this phenomenon is increasing at a huge rate of pace. Part 2. Impacts of watching porn. This one addiction at any age can ruin the relationship between couples, in career or social life. Many a times one is unable to realize this. Sex is a powerful motivational force which plays a vital role in evolving human race, but due to the frequent watching of porn and masturbation, the quality of sex decreases. It decreases human connection and people are becoming uncomfortable becoming social. This happens because one creates a different world in his, her brain and is most comfortable in it. Also, conversing to people makes them uncomfortable due to frequently keeping the picture of pornography in the mind. Heavy masturbators face the problem of ejaculation during intimacy with their partners. They are always dissatisfied with each other and their personal relations come to grief. The impact is a threat to emotional well-being, and with the time one has to understand this and solve issue. Part 3. Some may not accept the bad impact of porn. A Canadian researcher asked 20 students who are used to watch porn, of whether watching porn affects their mental conditioning and mental attitude. Their answers were no. But, according to JAMA Psychiatry Research, it proved that the result of watching porn reduces the grey matter and sexual responsiveness in people. Part 4. What is grey matter? Grey matter is made up of one's neural cell bodies, and in the 20s it is developed fully in one's brain. Due to reduction of grey matter, one can face problems in powers like vision, hearing, emotion, speech, decision-making and self-control issues. Part 5. Understanding the addiction. Within the last 5 years, the world's top neuroscientists have confirmed that addiction to pornography is real. Multiple studies have linked the addiction to a list of symptoms. They found that participants suffered from decreasing satisfaction leading to a search for more extreme material, sexual problems, decreased relationship satisfaction, reduced cognitive function and mental health problems. Their studies also found that men were able to cure themselves of these problems by eliminating their use of pornography. A big reason why people continually fail to overcome the addiction is a lack of understanding of the withdrawal symptoms. Urges, crazy thoughts, sleeplessness, feelings of hopelessness, despair, worthlessness, and many more negative things. These are a part of quitting PMO as your brain returns to normal functioning again. The flatline particularly scares people. They experience temporary, but absolute, loss of libido and abnormally lifeless genitals with no attraction to women at all. They rush back to PMO to check whether their sexual organ still works, and the withdrawal symptoms seem to fade away for a time for some people. The real cure is powering through and going months without the addiction to be healed. It is easy to estimate that nearly everyone under the age of 30 has seen pornography in different countries around the world. A study in Australia found that 100% of men under 30 and 82% of women had viewed pornography. In Western nations, around 28% of the population are heavily addicted. In 2017, 39% of men and 4% of women aged 15 to 29 viewed pornography daily. However, science and the media have not yet acknowledged pornography addiction as a genuine issue. This attitude means that millions are unaware that they are suffering symptoms which could be cured by stopping their pornography use. Social anxiety, low self-esteem, concentration issues, lack of motivation, depression, sexual dysfunction, and even suicidal thoughts. Moderate or severe addiction is associated with an increased risk of self-harm. However, society tells us that pornography only makes you feel good and that frequent masturbation prevents prostate cancer in men. Pornography producers admit that transgender pornography is made for straight audiences. They know that men will start to desire greater stimulation and arousal from more extreme sources as the addiction progresses. The brain can be trained to find anything arousing. But the straight men who view this will begin to question their sexuality and feel very disturbed with themselves as a result. Pornography addiction even made gay men watch lesbian pornography. A study of addicts in 2016 found that 20.7% of straight men watched gay pornography and 55% of gay men watched straight pornography. This issue is called HOCD or SOCD, homosexual sexual orientation obsessive compulsive disorder. Again, this goes away with extended time away from PMO. Dopamine is the craving chemical in your brain. It produces excellent sensations in your body when you engage in things like eating food, sexual activity, experiencing love or friendship when you experience the feeling of something new, a new present, new car, new phone, new game, new movie, etc. Dopamine is connected to the search for pleasure, not the actual pleasure itself. It causes the anticipation of pleasure. It motivates you to crave things the brain thinks will be beneficial for you, and it revives your brain to want those things more and more. It leads us to seek more and keeps us unsatisfied. When it comes to pornography, dopamine drives us to seek video after video, each one more extreme than the last. The brain believes you are really about to interact with these women and prepares to produce a child with as many women as possible and spread your genes. The sexual drive is the most effective genetic motivator we have. As such, an addiction to high-speed internet pornography is the most compulsive addiction possible, even higher than drug addiction. The addiction causes damage to our brain's prefrontal cortex. This is the CEO's desk in our brain, the control center. The control center is in charge of willpower, avoiding instant gratification and impulse control, and analyzing consequences before acting. This damage is part of the reason why people find it so difficult to quit. They're driving a car with low gas and flat tires. The brain is not working at its best capacity, but the good news is that with months spent away from pornography, this will be repaired as well. We have to push through the withdrawal symptoms to success on the other side, no matter how bad the cravings and urges are. Part 6. Benefits of breaking free. Men who developed an understanding of how their brain worked and how they were reinforcing negative, self-destructive habits were able to cut pornography out of their lives completely. They were once again attracted to their wives and girlfriends, and the symptoms disappeared. The brain is changeable. You can reverse your symptoms and replace your negative habits with positive ones. Of the few scientific studies that ask participants to give up pornography which have been conducted, those who gave up pornography saw improvement in their sexual health, loss of penile dysfunction, the return of natural arousal and intimacy in their relationships with wives and girlfriends, more exceptional success skills, better mental health and being more extroverted and engaging with others. Those who didn't experience these results were the people who had failed to quit their pornography addiction during the study. Addicts become less attracted to real men and women, authentic relationships with wives or husbands, girlfriends or boyfriends. In Japan, more than 20% of men no longer are interested in sexual intercourse. Similar results were found in Italy, France and the United States. They prefer pornography over real people. But after quitting pornography, those in relationships found that their sexual relations were better than ever before. They became so much more attracted to their wives, etc., that they no longer considered pornography to be appealing. People find after quitting that their social anxiety and shyness disappears. They can look people in the eyes again, have higher self-esteem and better senses of humor, and have increased female attraction. They become able to go to parties and events and enjoy social time at work or school, which they couldn't do previously. Part 7. Tips and strategies for overcoming the addiction. Delete all pornography, all downloads. Clear your browser history. Remove your bookmarks. Delete your dating apps and unfollow sexual pages on social media. Don't just leave it in the recycle bin. Purge it from your computer. No matter how extensive your collection is, or how long it took to collect, get rid of everything. Change your environment. If you usually watch pornography in your room, rearrange your furniture. Rearrange your desk. Move things around to change the cues in your brain. Use a pornography blocker and an ad blocker. Don't rely on it. Use it as a reminder that you don't want to watch pornography. Every blocker has loopholes you can get around, so don't rely on it. Use it as a tool to help build your self-control while your brain repairs its willpower. Get an accountability partner, have someone who is going through the addiction as well, who gets how difficult it is and will not judge you. Don't go through this alone. Speak to someone and support each other out of the addiction. Encourage each other, help each other through urges and work on your strategies and methods together. Keep a journal and record your progress. It will motivate you at times when it seems painful and you want to quit or you feel like you haven't made any progress. Engage in regular exercise. Exercise distracts your brain from urges, improves self-confidence and fitness, helps improve your mood and even enables you to heal from sexual dysfunction faster. It provides a good source of dopamine to counteract the urges to go back to PMO. Try out cold showers. They help build your willpower and improve your mood after you've got out of the cold water. Get outside in nature, walk through the park, breathe the fresh air and get some sunlight on your skin. Your brain will heal much faster and you'll experience the benefits sooner. Get outside and socialize. Spend more time with family and good friends. Interacting with others will heal your brain as well. If you suffer from social anxiety, find a straightforward interaction which you can do and make a game of it. For instance, try making eye contact and smiling with as many people as you can who pass by you on the street. You'll notice that you start getting better and your natural charisma will come out. You'll start saying, "Good afternoon," and "Hi there," to people. As you keep going, even working up to a conversation will become more comfortable. Meditation and prayer help repair the control center of your brain. Many people who have rebooted swear by their new practices of meditation and how it has improved their self-control. Engage in exciting, meaningful and productive habits and activities. You could learn a language, musical instrument or skill. Start cooking more. Work on personal projects and make use of your creativity. Read books you've always wanted to. You're showing your brain that you can enjoy other things, and with time, you'll gain more pleasure from them than you ever received from PMO. You'll also heal and experience the benefits of quitting faster. Go easy on yourself. Don't beat yourself up if you fall. Pick yourself up, learn from your mistakes, refine your strategy and keep going. Appreciate that you're on this journey and making a difference to improve your life. Learn more about what's happening in your brain and how addiction works. Learn about the withdrawal symptoms and what to expect, so they don't lead you to relapse. Thousands of people who learned this found it much easier to understand their triggers and urges and were able to succeed. Keep yourself inspired regularly. Read success stories of the thousands of people who have succeeded in quitting pornography. Recognize that you don't need 90 days of constant willpower. You need to build the habit of choosing to say no every time the urge comes. This realization makes the journey more bearable. It's not as much of a fight. Get over the shame of what you've done and your previous lack of self-control. Find a way to come to terms with your past and remove the guilt and shame. Shame increases the addictive tendencies and encourages binging. Be compassionate towards yourself and look forward towards the future instead of back at the dark past you're leaving behind. Prepare yourself from urges before they happen. Decide what positive activities you will engage in instead of giving in to the urge. Figure out your reasons why these activities will help you at that moment. Think about what situations you can do them in. Can you do them when you're tired? In the shower, at work or at school? Make a list of all the reasons why you want to quit PMO and the reasons why you want to be free, and have the list ready to consult whenever the urges come. Don't ignore your urges. Always take immediate action by acknowledging them. Say this to yourself: here are cravings. They came out of nowhere and they have no real power over me. I am not my thoughts, I did not summon them, I do not want them, and I do not have to act on them. Within 15 minutes, the urge will go away, and you'll be fine until the next urge comes. Recognize that you're stronger than the urge. Always. No matter how long it takes, you can overcome it. Some people do this every time a sexual thought like a pornographic flashback comes into their mind. They envision a large, red X over it, and imagine hearing loud, ambulance sirens. They do this immediately, and the process becomes automatic with habit. For insistent images, they go further and imagine the red X exploding. Do you keep giving yourself an excuse like, I will do it one last time, or, today is the last time? Change it to, just today I am not doing it. Live as if porn didn't exist. Completely forget about it. Don't spend your day fighting urges. Don't try hard. Be okay with the idea that you will never watch porn again in your life. If you find this book helpful, th3n like this video, and if you're not subscribe our channel, then subscribe us. And if you want to read this book, then link is in description box, go and order.